Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 25th of June. Delhi is now the worst hit city in India as number of COVID-19 cases crossed 70,000. Pilots in Pakistan crash were chatting about coronavirus, says aviation minister. And Nepal's opposition files petition against Chinese encroachment, urges government to bring back territory. And now for all the details. With the highest single-day spike of 16,922 cases in the last 24 hours, India's COVID-19 count reached 473,105 on Thursday. Delhi has overtaken Mumbai as the city with the highest case count. Amid rising cases, the Delhi government has prepared an ambitious plan, house-to-house screening in containment zones by July 30 and in the rest of the city by July 6. India on Thursday saw a sharp spike of nearly 17,000 coronavirus cases. The country's total count of infection now stands at 473,105. More than 14,900 have died from the highly contagious virus. Amid rising cases, the Delhi government has prepared an ambitious plan, house-to-house screening in containment zones by June 30 and in rest of the city by July 6. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal launched video call facility for COVID-19 patients admitted at Lok Nayak Jayaprakash or LNJP hospital.
एक जो दिक्कत आ रही थी कि जब आपके पेशेंट अंदर हैं तो बाहर रिलेटिव्स उनसे बात नहीं कर पाते थे, उनको पता नहीं चलता था अंदर क्या, तो आज वो सुविधा शुरू की है.
Meanwhile, to cope up with the rising cases and overwhelmed healthcare system in Delhi, the federal government has called in the army and paramilitary to manage new treatment centers with thousands of additional hospital beds in the city. India's Interior Ministry said the city would have around 20,000 additional beds available by next week at temporary facilities run by army doctors and nurses. At least two terrorists were killed by security forces in an encounter in Baramulla district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Thursday. According to officials, the encounter began after security forces launched a joint search operation earlier in the day after receiving input about the presence of the terrorists.
At least two terrorists were killed in an encounter by security forces in Baramulla district of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir on Thursday. The encounter began on Thursday morning after a joint team of Indian Army, local police and paramilitary Central Reserve Police Force or CRPF launched a cordon and search operation in Sopore. Two to three terrorists were believed to be trapped at the encounter site. The encounter was still underway till the last reports came in. Earlier on Tuesday, two terrorists were also killed in a similar encounter. A CRPF personnel also lost his life in the encounter in Pulwama district of Jammu and Kashmir. So far, over 100 terrorists have been eliminated by security forces in Jammu and Kashmir this year. India blames neighboring Pakistan helps terrorists infiltrate across the border to mount attacks on Indian soil. Security officials have claimed despite coronavirus pandemic, there has been a spike in activities by Pakistan-backed terror groups.
In news from Afghanistan, coronavirus is changing the world in unprecedented ways. As the crisis has affected the lives of vulnerable people in Afghanistan too, government is employing jobless workers to rehabilitate groundwater supplies, addressing two urgent challenges at once: keeping the economy running through the pandemic and tackling climate change.
As lockdown measures imposed amid coronavirus outbreak have taken their toll on Afghanistan's workforce, the government is employing more than 40,000 jobless workers to rehabilitate groundwater supplies for fast-growing capital city of Kabul. The project run by state's National Development Corporation uses trenches to capture rainwater and snow melt that is usually lost through flash flooding. A cook by profession, 28-year-old Zakir Hussain Zahiri, who was making a good living until Afghanistan went into coronavirus lockdown, now digs a series of trenches on a mountain in the outskirts of capital Kabul, aimed at saving the city from a water crisis while earning money to afford his family's daily needs.
ما که بودم از پیش آشپز بودم در یکی از رستوران‌های شهر کابل و بعد از اینکه امی ویروس کرونا در کشور ما آمد کابل قرنطینه شد خصوصا کل افغانستان قرنطینه شد ما از وظیفه خود از دست دادیم آشپز بودیم و حالی آمدیم در یک پروژه آپراسیونی شهر کابل همینجا بحیث کارگر کار میکنیم
Plan to run for at least a year, the $155 million water project pays laborers at least $3.9 a day to dig close to 150,000 trenches along with 17 small dams and spillways on the outskirts of the mountainous Afghan capital. Afghanistan has joined a growing group of countries that are turning to green stimulus projects to address two urgent challenges at once, keeping the economy running through the pandemic and tackling climate change. Meanwhile, Afghanistan, which remains under a lockdown, has recorded 29,715 cases of the coronavirus and 639 deaths so far.
Moving on, a protest was held recently by doctors and health workers in Gilgit-Baltistan, raising concerns over lack of facilities to deal with coronavirus crisis in the illegally occupied region, where they highlighted their plight of lack of PPEs to treat COVID-19 patients.
Doctors treating COVID-19 patients demonstrated in front of the Chief Minister's residential compound in Gilgit to seek immediate redressal of a host of problems they are enduring. Safety equipment while treating COVID-19 patients and security from all kinds of violence against healthcare staff were two key demands. While a large number of them have contracted the virus in the past few weeks, owing to the absence of proper safety gear while attending patients, a whole lot of others have been targeted by an unruly mob for various reasons.
Our demand is that in the front, at this time, I believe that our many lady doctors, male doctors, our PMA's own president, Dr. Iqbal, and many surgeons at this time, COVID patients have been already, and some under treatment at this time. लिहाजा हम ये गुजारिश करते हैं कि इन सब को प्रोटेक्टिव किट्स आला क्वालिटी के वाफिर मिकदार में मुहैया किए जाएं।
गिलगित बल्तिस्तान हैज रिपोर्टेड 1,365 कोरोनावायरस केसेस विद 23 डेथ्स सो फार एंड द केसेस कंटिन्यू टू राइज अमिड राइजिंग केसेस डॉक्टर्स आल्सो डिमांडेड एन एक्सक्लूसिव कोविड-19 हॉस्पिटल एंड एन आइसोलेशन सेंटर इन द रीजन As they say, the current capacity of hospitals has been overwhelmed by the rapid rise in the count of patients with the virus.
पहली बात हम ये डिमांड करते हैं कि इस वक्त जो वबा है, जो करंट सिचुएशन है, इसमें हम हुकाम बाला से और बाब इख्तियार से ये डिमांड करते हैं कि जनाब कोरोना अस्पताल के लिए पूरे मुल्क में कोरोना पेशेंट के एक आइसोलेशन सेंटर और एक अलग हॉस्पिटल का कायम अमल में लाया गया है लिहाजा हम गुजारिश करते हैं कि फिल फोर एक अरसे हम इसी एहतजाज में हैं कि कोरोना के पेशेंट्स के लिए सस्पेक्ट्स के लिए एक्टिव पेशेंट्स के लिए एक अलग हॉस्पिटल का कायम अमल में लाया जाए
गिलगित बल्तिस्तान हैड रिपोर्टेड फर्स्ट क्लस्टर्स ऑफ कोरोना वायरस एज अर्ली एज मार्च आफ्टर अ नंबर ऑफ पिलग्रिम्स हु हैड रिटर्न्ड फ्रॉम ईरान वर फाउंड पॉजिटिव But the authorities, who have forever acted carelessly in matters of this illegally occupied region, didn't bother to address even this grave health crisis.
Pilots of a Pakistan airliner that crashed last month, killing 97, were distracted and preoccupied as they talked about coronavirus pandemic, Pakistan's aviation minister has said. The Airbus A320 of national carrier Pakistan International Airlines crashed on May 22nd, in the southern city of Karachi, killing all but two of those aboard.
The pilots of a Pakistan airliner that crashed last month, killing 97, were distracted and preoccupied as they talked about the coronavirus pandemic while preparing for an initial failed attempt to land. Pakistan's aviation minister, Ghulam Sarwar Khan, said on Wednesday. As he presented an initial report on the disaster, Khan told the parliament that the engines of the aircraft had touched the ground as it landed without its wheels down on the first attempt, before taking off again. The aircraft was 100% fit to fly and there was no technical fault, he said, but added that the pilots were not focused because of the pandemic.
Pilot aur co-pilot focused nahi the. Unke zehen pe corona sawar tha. Unki family mutasir thi. Aur wo corona hi ki discussion kar rahe the. लैंडिंग में आया, लैंडिंग पोजीशन पे आया तो कंट्रोल टावर ने उसे मना किया कि आप ज्यादा हाइट पे हैं, आप नीचे आए. तो बड़ी जल्दी में उसने उसकी कॉल सुनी और उसने कहा यार मैं मैनेज कर लूंगा.
द एयरबस A320 ऑफ पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल एयरलाइंस क्रैश्ड ऑन May 22 इन द सदर्न सिटी ऑफ कराची, किलिंग ऑल बट टू ऑफ दोज अबोर्ड.
In news from Nepal, three lawmakers of Nepal's opposition party Nepali Congress have moved a motion in the lower house of parliament on the Nepalese land encroached by China. According to the motion, 64 hectares have been encroached upon Dolakha, Hamla, Sindhupal Chowk, Sakhu Vasaba, Gorkha and Rasuwa districts of Nepal by China. This comes after a report prepared by the Survey Department of Agriculture Ministry showed a list of 11 places of which China has encroached on 10 places comprising about 33 hectares of Nepali land by diverting the flow of rivers which act as a natural boundary. Nepali Congress has been demanding answers from Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's government over the Chinese encroachment for some time now. The Oli government has maintained silence on the issue with no reaction so far. Nepal and China share 141,488 square kilometer long border. After easing lockdown, the administration has resumed both services in India's spiritual capital of Varanasi city, saying both services was essential to support the economically unprivileged boatman community. The decision has also brought happiness among locals. District Administration of India's spiritual capital of Varanasi city resumed boat services in Ganges River this week after a shutdown of over 3 months, even as the cases of COVID-19 continued to soar in the country. The district administration said the resuming of boat services was essential to support the economically underprivileged boatman community.
इतनी इसमें बहुत खुशी है भैया, बहुत गरीब तबके के लोग हैं नौका संचालन करने वाले. अगर जो रोज नौका चलाते हैं वही उनके घर चूल्हा जलता है. जब से नौका संचालन रुका हुआ है तब से आपको बता रहे कि समाज के प्रति में इतनी गरीबी है कि वो अपना जीविका नहीं चला पा रहे थे. और जैसे ही नौका संचालन की बात, जैसे ही DM साहब ने आदेश दिया, उसके बाद बहुत समाज के लोगों में बड़ी खुशी की लहर है.
बोट राइड्स ऑफ वाराणसी आर एन इंटीग्रल एलिमेंट ऑफ अ विजिट टू द हिंदू स्पिरिचुअल टाउन. They are popular for the views of sunrise and sunset through the majesty of holy Ganges River.
सरकार ने ये इजाजत दी है 84 दिन बाद जो खुला है, और हम लोग इसके जब सुने हम लोग ये खबर तो रह नहीं पाए और तुरंत हम लोग जिद करके यहाँ पे आए हैं. अपनी मम्मी के साथ मैं आई हूँ यहाँ पे और नाव में सैर किया.
The Indian government had implemented the world's largest complete lockdown of 1.3 billion people for about 2 months to curb the rapid spread of coronavirus in the country. It had shut down all the services including boats and only essential services were allowed. Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Delhi is now the worst hit city in India as number of COVID-19 cases cross 70,000. Pilots in Pakistan crash were chatting about coronavirus, says aviation minister. And Nepal's opposition files petition against Chinese encroachment, urges government to bring back territory. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.